भूलवाल आसछे
अ वेरी गुड आफ्टरनून एंड अ वार्म वेलकम टू अनदर लाइव सेशन ऑफ बीएम बिरला हार्ट रिसर्च सेंटर कोलकाता एज पार्ट ऑफ वर्ल्ड हार्ट मंथ प्रोग्राम we are coming up with a series of Facebook live sessions with our star doctors who will be talking about various aspects of the heart and the heart problems. So we have today with us Dr. Shubho Datta, who has been associated with BM Birla Hospital since the inception. With about 30 years of experience, it is needless to mention the large volume of procedures he has performed. He has done many first-time procedures in India during this period and is a faculty member in many international conferences throughout the world. Dr. Shubho Datta will be taking us through the causes and treatment of sudden cardiac arrest. Sir, can you please enlighten us on this subject? Fine. Welcome.
Thank you, Priyanka. Welcome, everybody. This is a general topic, a very important topic which I'll be discussing. Is sudden cardiac arrest and the treatment. Let us take you through a story. Suppose you are waiting for your car outside in the road and suddenly you find someone collapse. What do you do? Do you check his pockets for an ID card to bring him home? Number one. Number two, do you take call the police? Do you call the ambulance? So of these three, what do you do? Well, it's a tough job. You start thinking what to do. Well, let me do the reverse. I will be the person who was waiting for the car and someone collapses. What do I do? I think that would be easier. I rush to the patient and call him, hello, hello. Any response? No response. That means the patient is unconscious. The next thing I do is feel his pulse. You can feel your pulse out here and dug, 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 this bouncing pulse, I feel that. Yes, his pulse is good. I put my hand on his chest. He is breathing up and down. So I know he is not dead. I call for the ambulance. And the ambulance takes him to the hospital. The second aspect is a person who I rush, who has collapsed, to find that I can't find his pulse. I can't feel his pulse. Then I find that he is not breathing properly. That means his heart is not pumping. In this extreme situation, it becomes a life-threatening area where I have to involve myself actively. There's no time for thought. So as soon as I find that he's unconscious, the first thing I do is put a thud on his chest and start cardiac massage. And the cardiac massage, the simple thing is, this is the heart, this is the rib, and behind is the backbone. Between this, we compress the heart by pumping it like this, so that the heart empties its blood, the whole body and brain, and we keep on doing this 30 times and two aspects of breathing till we find the pulse coming back. If we don't find the pulse coming back, we continue cardiac massage till we find that the pulse has come. We pursue this at least minimum 45 minutes. In the meantime, the ambulance arrives, the ambulance paramedics take over the patient, and the paramedics take care. So I have done my job. This is basically basic life support I have given in the outside world. As soon as, suppose the patient comes to BM Birla Heart Center, to our hospital, and is wheeled in to our emergency, my doctors and nurses will put an alert, code blue, activation. Immediately, anesthetist, a senior nurse, a resident medical officer will rush to the emergency department to help the doctors and nurses in the emergency department with the patient. The anesthetist will check the breathing, whether ventilation is required. The nurses will continue with a cardiac massage and they will hook the patient onto a monitor screen and they will see what's going on with the heart. Is the heart beating or why can't we feel the pulse? And to our surprise, we find that there is a long pause. There's no heartbeat. So during this period, cardiac massage continues. And as soon as the heartbeat comes back, here, tuck, tuck, tuck. Sorry. Here, tuck, tuck, tuck. So we shift the patient with ventilation to CCU. And after that, the patient undergoes stabilization for the investigation and treatment. Patient may require a pacemaker. If this was a complication of a heart attack, patient may require an angiography followed by procedures like angioplasty, bypass surgery. That is afterwards. But extreme situation is when you are massaging and you are not getting back to your rhythm. That time you have to shift the patient on to the ambulance with cardiac massage and see what we find. Here if you see, this is a heartbeat, duck, 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 duck. And then here you see, it's all so what has happened? The heart was beating like this, suddenly it has gone into a vibration mode and it's not beating. So this is the most dangerous, it's called ventricular fibrillation, and 99% of us die because of this rhythm. So it is imperative that this should be taken care of as soon as possible. Such a patient, once wheeled in and hooked onto the monitor, and we see this sort of rhythm, there is no time. While CPR is going on, we take this machine. We take this machine and charge the machine and give a shock immediately and see. No response. We increase the power of energy and we deliver a second shock on the chest, heart. No response, cardiac massage continues, a third shock. And then suddenly we notice in the monitor, dig, 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 the heartbeat has come back. So we have revived the patient. The patient is stabilized and sent with ventilator to CCU. Now, this patient will require certain things. He has made it to the hospital. He's a survivor of sudden cardiac arrest. He will not get a second chance. And such survivors will need 100% effective treatment. What is this effective treatment? This is called an ICD, intracardiac. That was before I showed, was a machine where we delivered the shock. This is an ICD which we pass through a little incision here, about 3 or 4 inches. We make a small pocket and through a blood vessel, we pass this into the heart. We screw it and then we connect this with the ICD and then we put this in the pocket and stitch it up. Here is an example of the ICD in place. You can see the ICD here. There.
This is the, I think, the device.
Yeah, yes. That is a device. And can you show the wire, please? The top wire? Yes. This is the wire lead. And you can see that this is going to scan the heart muscle 24 hours. And any rhythm problem that comes, it will automatically sense and deliver a shock and save the patient. The problem is, when such patients go home and are at work in office and they get a shock, they come rushing back to hospital. Doctor Datta, I've got a shock. I tell them, my dear friend, I have given my best doctor and nurse with you. He's taking care of your heart. Why are you back with me? Now you don't need to come to BM Builder. You are saved. So this is the little story of sudden cardiac arrest. And I take you through a small story of experience of my own life. My relatives were all going on a pilgrimage to Kedarnath and Badrinath. My uncle, aunt, their friends, total around 23, 25 plus. So they were all in Howrah station, all gossiping, drinking tea, biscuits and munching chanachur and all that. The train was entering the platform and everyone was getting ready to board the train. I went to see my parents off, as both my mother and father were also going in the same trip. I noticed suddenly my uncle, he fell down. No one noticed, I noticed. I rushed, I saw what happened. I felt he was breathing. I called him, his name, he was not responding. I felt no pulse. I started CPR. By that time, I think all the relatives got to know something is going on. They came and all started looking. Some started crying. Some thought he was dead. Some were confused. 15 to 20 minutes, I continued doing cardiac massage alone. Then I found that he was making some sounds. I realized his brain circulation was coming back. I could feel his pulse. And gradually he opened his eyes. No time wasted. I took him in my car, drove in the back seat, flat, drove the car myself, directly to B.M. Birla Hospital, CCU. He survived. We did an angiogram. He had a heart attack. He required bypass surgery. Subsequently, he is still alive, doing well. Unfortunately, this is one part of the story where he survived. Unfortunately, 2 years back, his son was having a night out with his friends. He was not even 40. And suddenly he collapsed. And he passed away. So I think the lesson or take home message here is, you know, awareness is a bliss. Awareness saved my uncle. And loss of awareness, I lost my cousin. So what the mind doesn't know, the eyes will never see. I think that is the basic take-home message of today's talk. I hope you've learned something from this, and I hope you'll take back some messages. And if you are interested in these CPR sessions, we do hold them from time to time. You can contact our marketing department, and we have dummy. We've done this quite a few times in Tolly Club. We do this all the time.
Sir, one question which I would like to ask. Do you have any, we have seen a lot of young patients, young people who are suffering from cardiac arrest or have heart problems. Do you have any tips or any precautionary measures which they can take to avoid these problems?
Yes, because in India, unfortunately, the age group is 40 plus, whereas in the West, it is around 70 plus. So it is very important that during this prime age, of when they are fully involved with work, that they look after their heart by taking healthy food, exercising, and you know, avoiding smoking. And if they have families, they should avoid, you know, fast food as well, as much as possible.
Right, sir. So thank you so much for taking such an effort for our viewers and explaining so beautifully the entire concept. Thank you, viewers, for your time. Just at the end, I would like to mention, for any information that you require regarding heart, for any appointments that you need for our hospital, you can give us a call at 033-4088-4088. Till then, take care and stay healthy and stay safe. Thank you.
Thank you.